Principal, President of the Board of Governors, officers from the services, invited guests, ladies, gentlemen, and friends from the media. I feel nostalgic, honored, and privileged to be here this evening on the annual day function of Delhi College. This institution has come a long way, and from what we could gather from the annual report, it is evident that a child that comes to this school gets all-round development. They come to learn and they leave to serve. I wish to compliment the NCC cadets who presented a very smartly turned out guard of honor. My best wishes to them. My greetings, best wishes, and compliments to the faculty, staff, and students who displayed the various art forms, artifacts during the exhibition that we got the opportunity to witness. It was crafts, it was science, it was mathematics, it was technology, and it was magic. Everything was there. My compliments to each one of you. I would also like to take this opportunity to convey my compliments to the award winners who won prizes and medals and trophies for their respective houses, for themselves in particular. My best wishes to them. At the same time, we would not like to discourage those who could not earn these awards or rewards. Most of you may be aware that in the yonder years when the Olympics were played in Athens in Greece, there were no medals. There was no gold, there was no silver, there was no bronze. All that the winner got was a wreath of olive. And why was that? Because the olive leaves would wither away after some time. And therefore, every time a sportsman entered the arena, he got a reward which withered away. And so you had to repeatedly perform to get that reward year after year. And so what I wish to highlight is that success is not permanent. Success will keep coming to you as long as you keep working hard. So there is always time for those who could not earn rewards or awards during this year's college function. Your time will come. Today I stand here behind this podium. With nostalgia, I remember my own school days. Way back in 1973, when I graduated with a senior Cambridge certificate from St. Edward's School, Shimla. Times have changed, things have changed. During our days in school, we studied, we played. There was very little time for television because there were only one or two channels which your parents won't allow you to fetch. There were no mobile phones, there was no, very rarely there was internet for very few who could afford it. So it was only study, play, become rowdy with friends, you rub shoulders with old school types, and that is how life went on. Today a child who comes to school gets all round development because of the means of communication that are available today with you. Remember, you will make friends for life. A Dalian once will be a Dalian forever. When you leave school and you move out, no matter where you are, in the country or outside, when you see a Dalian, there will be a different chemistry that will start developing between you. I have experienced it with my own schoolmates, so I have no reason to believe why it won't happen or doesn't happen with the Dalians. So what you learn here is what we carry with you, you carry forward with you. You make friends in school for life. You may forget your near and dear ones, but you will never forget people from your school, particularly those from your batch. I wish to convey my compliments to the founders of the school, who have laid very strong foundations. And that is why the school stands steadfast, delivering high quality education, developing high sense of responsibility amongst the students, preparing you to become good future citizens of this nation. Remember, you children today in school are the future of our country. What you will learn from here is what you must carry with you as you step out of school, whether you join college or you go anywhere else. You must remember that it will always be your country first, everything that matters for you only after that. You must learn to shoulder responsibility for your actions. What I imply by that is that do not think you are alone in the society. You have to work for the betterment of the society, work for the betterment of those who have not been so fortunate to get the kind and quality of education that has been imparted to you at Delhi College. Remember to take them along with you and never leave them behind. You are the future of our nation. And whenever you think big, aim high. There is no end to destiny. If you think big and you aim high, you will achieve what you wish to achieve. But do not ever get disappointed by failures. There will be failures in life. But each failure must strengthen you to strive harder for success. Success comes to those only who persevere, who work hard, display honesty and integrity. If you remember this, you will succeed. There will be difficult times which you will have to face in your journey through life. always be prepared to choose the harder right over the easier wrong. And let me tell you, you will never fail. Success will come your way if you follow this diction. There are many examples of very ordinary people who achieve success. In the army, I have seen soldiers and officers who appeared to be ordinary. But when the time came, they rose above everything and proved their worth. Many of you would have heard of Subedar Bana Singh, a very diminutive person, little over 5 feet tall, very unassuming. But when the time came, he captured the Qaid post held by the Pakistanis on the Siachen Glacier, which is now named after him as the Bana Post. He was awarded the country's highest gallantry order, honor, the Paramveer Chakra. Many of you would have heard of Captain Vikram Batra, who went up the mountains in Kargil and raised the slogan, Ye Dil Mange More. And he carried on and on and on till he achieved what he wished to achieve and finally sacrificed his life for the nation. In my own regiment was Captain Manoj Pandey, who when tasked to capture a very high mountain in Kargil, told his commanding officer as he left his base for the attack, and he said, Ya to Tiranga upar lehra ke aunga, या तिरंगे में लिपट के वापस आऊंगा. He came back wrapped in the Tiranga after having accomplished his mission at Polo Lake and was again awarded posthumously the highest gallantry award, the Paramveer Chakra. So children, you don't have to be 6 feet tall, 200 pounds strong to be an achiever. To be an achiever, you have to think big, aim high, and just remember God. There is a God who will help you if you help yourself. And you help yourself only through hard work. Results will come your way. Never ever bother about the results. Because there will be somebody who's first, there will be somebody who's second, but it does not mean that they are the best. As I said, success is only temporary. Remember, your day will come. As I stand here, how can I forget about the Indian Army? We look forward to very bright pupils from this school joining the defense services, because I believe this is a service which is dedicated to the nation. And we'll be only too glad if more of you consider this as your profession. Today, as I scan through the audience, I see a number of alumni who have donned the uniform. In fact, my own 8D camp, my ADC along with me, Captain Ranawat, is also a Dalian from the 2007 batch. He joined the special forces and is serving in my staff at the Army headquarters with me. He makes us proud. And there are many of you who have made us proud, and there is no end to how many of you can make us proud in the future. What does the army tell us? We believe in certain values of honesty, equality, justice, dedication, courage, loyalty, integrity, honor, commitment and sacrifice. This is inbuilt within all of us. You have to only join a force like the army to show your talent to your peers, to your comrades, to your army and to the nation. When we all join the academy and finally emerge from there after having become commissioned officers, all of us remember the motto by Philip Chetwood and inscribed in the Chetwood building at the Indian Military Academy, Chetwoodian motto states that the safety, honor and welfare of your country comes first always and every time. The honor, welfare and comfort of the men you command comes next. Your own comfort and ease come last always and every time. Unfortunately, some of us have started reversing the motto. But I think we have to adopt this motto, follow this motto, and carry on with this motto. And if each one of you adopts this motto, there is no way you will not succeed. And finally, in the end, I will be failing my duty. If you do not compliment the faculty and staff who have nurtured you, groomed you to become excellent students, who will now be stepping out. Some of you from this batch will be stepping out, others will follow in the years to come as honored and true citizens of our nation. Blessed are also your parents who have sent their wards to a very prestigious Delhi College for achieving the kind and quality of education which would be the envy of many, because this institution imparts the kind of education which many of us may strive for. Remember, there is a difference between knowledge and education. What Delhi College is imparting to you is education and not knowledge alone. Knowledge can be captured from the books that you may read. Education is the holistic development which a school like Delhi College has given to each one of you. My compliments to the course or the batch which will be graduating this year from school. My best wishes to the students who will graduate in the subsequent years. And I may compliment, and I wish to compliment the principal, the board of governors, the staff, faculty and teachers for having given me this opportunity to be here amongst you, to be a part of you on this historic occasion. I am indeed grateful to you. Thank you once again, ladies and gentlemen, and Jai Hind.
Thank you, sir.